welcome to math class.
Children, do you remember who is Farah? Yes, Farah is a florist. She used to sell bouquets and flowers. Today we are going to continue the same story. Let us move on to the story. Children, previously Farah used to sell the bouquets in her shop only. It cost her 300 rupees to make one bouquet. And she used to sell it for 350 rupees. Yes or no, children? Now, let us see, is Farah is going to sell the bouquets in the same manner or not? Children, Farah decided to expand her business. So, she created a website through which she started taking the orders through online and started delivering the bouquets. For this process, she hired delivery boys to deliver the bouquets in time and to the exact place. Children, now tell me, is the cost price of the bouquets is going to be same? No, the cost price of the bouquets is going to be increased due to some expenses like transportation, rent, salaries, etc. Now, let us see what are these expenses called and how to find profit and loss. Children, sometimes the price of an object increases due to other expenses like transportation, shop rent, salaries, etc. These are called overheads and these are added to the cost price. To get the final cost, overheads are added to the cost price. Now children, let us see how much Farah is going to charge as overheads on each bouquet. What is the selling price of each bouquet and profit on each bouquet? Children, as you know, cost price of the bouquet is 300 rupees and Farah decided to charge 75 rupees on each bouquet as overheads. So, overhead charges are 75 rupees on each bouquet and she decided to sell the bouquet for 450 rupees. Now children, tell me, the cost price of the bouquet is only 300 rupees? No, we have to include overhead charges also to find the final cost of the bouquet. Final cost is equal to CP plus overheads, that is 300 rupees plus 75 rupees. The sum is 375 rupees, which is the final cost of the bouquet. Now, this final cost is compared with the selling price, which is 450 rupees. Children, what did you observe here? Exactly, SP is greater than CP. So, the difference is profit. To find profit, we have to subtract cost price from selling price. SP minus CP, that is 450 rupees minus 375 rupees, the difference is 75 rupees, which is profit for Farah on each bouquet. Children, one day Farah ordered a microwave oven, a school bag and roller skates in online. Let us see the cost price, selling price and overhead charges of these things and let us find out whether it is profit or loss to the seller. Children, Farah ordered roller skates for her son Chintu. Look at here children, what is the cost price? 2100 rupees, overheads 395 rupees and the selling price is 2300 rupees. Children, these are the sums from exercise 2D, third bit. Let us start. Children, as we discussed earlier, the cost price of an object increases due to some expenses. What are these expenses called, children? Overhead charges. When overhead charges are given, we need to find the final cost. So, to find the final cost, we have to add overheads to the cost price. CP plus overheads, that is 2100 rupees plus 395 rupees, which is 2495 rupees is the final cost of the roller skates. Now this final cost is
compared with selling price, which is 2300 rupees. What did you observe, children? Exactly. CP is greater than SP. So, the difference is loss. To find loss, we have to subtract SP from CP. That is 2495 rupees minus 2300 rupees. The difference is 195 rupees, which is loss to the seller. Children, always we have to add overheads to the cost price only. Children, Farah also ordered a school bag for her daughter Mona. Look at here, children. Cost price 645 rupees, overheads 80 rupees, and the selling price is 800 rupees. Children, first we have to find out final cost. Final cost is equal to CP plus overheads. That is 645 rupees plus 80 rupees. The sum is 725 rupees, which is the final cost of the bag. Now this final cost is compared with selling price, which is 800 rupees. What did you observe, children? Exactly. Selling price is greater than cost price. So the difference is profit. To find profit, we have to subtract cost price from selling price, SP minus CP. That is 800 rupees minus 725 rupees. The difference is 75 rupees, which is profit to the seller on the bag. Children, Farah also ordered a microwave oven. Look at here, children. Cost price 7213 rupees, overheads 520 rupees, and the selling price is 9818 rupees. Children, first we have to find out final cost. Final cost is equal to CP plus overheads. That is 7213 rupees plus 520 rupees. The sum is 7733 rupees, which is the final cost of the woven. Now this final cost is compared with the selling price. What did you observe, children? Exactly. Selling price is greater than cost price. So, the difference is profit. To find profit, we have to subtract cost price from selling price, SP minus CP. That is 9818 rupees minus 7733 rupees. The difference is 2085 rupees, which is profit to the seller.
Children, let us do some word problems on profit and loss from exercise 2D, fourth bit solve. Here is the question. A collector buys a painting for 3500 rupees but sells it for 2750 rupees. Find the gain or loss. Here the word gain is nothing but profit, children. Profit is also called as gain. So children, before finding whether it is profit or loss, let us write down the cost price and selling price of the painting. Here, look at here, children. A collector buys. Buys means he purchased. He purchased means here 3500 rupees. He purchased for 3500 rupees, which is the cost price of the painting. And he sells it for. He sells it means he sold the painting for 2750 rupees. So 2750 rupees is the selling price of the painting. So let us start solution. Given that CP of a painting. Okay, children, CP of a painting 3500 rupees. What is SP, children? SP of a painting 2750 rupees. Okay, children, now observe
CP and SP. What did you observe, children, here? Exactly. CP is greater than SP. Here, CP is greater than SP. So, in the previous classes, already we have seen, in this class also, you have already gone through, when CP is greater than SP, what will get, children? Exactly, it is loss. So, it is loss. To find loss, what we have to do, children? To find loss, SP is subtracted from CP, means CP minus SP. Okay, children, loss means CP minus SP. Come on, let us subtract that. What is CP, children? 3,500 rupees minus, what is SP, children? SP of the painting? 2,750. So, children, 3,500 minus 2,750. Let us subtract. 3,500 minus 2,750. 0 minus 0? 0. 0 minus 5 is not possible subtraction with regrouping. So, here 5 will become 4 and 0 will become 10. 10 minus 5, 5. 4 minus 7, again not possible, again regroup. So, 3 here will become 2 and 4 will become 14. 14 minus 7, 7. 2 minus 2, 0. So, children, what is the loss? 750 rupees is the loss to the collector. Okay. So, last statement, what we have to write? Thus, loss is 750 rupees. So, this is the last statement, children. 750 rupees is the loss on the painting. Okay, children. So, when CP is greater than SP, the difference is loss. To find loss, we have to subtract selling price from cost price. Let us do one more sum. A calculator that costs 517 rupees is sold at 575 rupees. What is the profit that is made? Okay, children. So, first we have to find out what is the cost price of the calculator and what is the selling price of the calculator. If you observe here, a calculator that costs, the word itself you might have understood. So, here 517 rupees is the cost price of the calculator and sold at 575 rupees, means 575 rupees is the selling price of the calculator. Cost price is 517 rupees and whereas selling price is 575 rupees. So, we already understood because SP is greater than CP. So, we get profit. So, that they have given what is the profit that is made. Let us start the solution. So, solution given that CP, cost price of a calculator. What is the cost price, children? 517 rupees. And what is the selling price, children? Selling price of a calculator. What is the selling price, children? Yes, 575 rupees. Okay. So, as already we discussed here, selling price is greater than cost price. So, when selling price is greater than cost price, what will get, children? Yes, the difference is profit. So, SP is greater than CP. It is profit. So, to find profit, what we have to do, children? CP, cost price, is subtracted from selling price. SP minus CP. SP minus CP. So, what is SP, children? 575 rupees minus What is CP children? 517 rupees. Let us subtract. 575 minus 517. 5 minus 7 is not possible. So this is subtraction with the regrouping. So regroup from 7. 7 will become 6 and 5 will become 15. 15 minus 7, 8. Okay children. Now 6 minus 1. 6 minus 1, 5. 5 minus 5, 0. So what is profit children? 58 rupees is profit. Thus, profit is 58 rupees. Okay children, so when selling price is greater than cost price, it is profit. To find profit, we have to subtract cost price from selling price. So the profit here is 58 rupees. Let us do one more sum. Children, look at the next question. A furniture mart buys an old sofa set for 5380 rupees. They spend 1840 rupees to put new covers on it and sell it for 8000 rupees. What is the profit or loss? First, they purchased a sofa set for 5380 rupees, that is CP of the sofa set. After that, to bring new covers, so they spent again 1840 rupees on the old sofa set. What is this 1840 children? Yes, exactly, 1840 rupees is the, they are the overhead charges. Yes or no children? So to put new covers, again they spent 1840 rupees. So this 1840 rupees is nothing but the overhead charges. After that, they again they sold it for 8000 rupees. So children, to find out whether it is profit or loss, what we have to find out first? Exactly, when overhead charges are there, first we have to find out the final cost. What is final cost children? Final cost is nothing but CP plus overhead charges. Then the final cost is compared with the selling price. Then we will understand whether it is profit or loss. Yes or no children? Let us start the solution. Solution. What is CP of old sofa set children? 5380 rupees. And overheads? Overheads 1840 rupees. Now, what is the SP of sofa set children? It is 8000 rupees. Okay, first what we have to find children? So, CP and overheads we have to add. That is final cost. What is final cost children? CP plus overheads. Okay children, what is CP? 5380 rupees plus 1840 rupees. Let us add. 5380 rupees plus 1840 rupees. Let us add children. 0 plus 0, 0. 8 plus 4, 12. So, addition with the regrouping. So, 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 8, 12. 1 plus 5, 6. 6 plus 1, 7. So, what is the final cost of the sofa set children? 7,220 rupees. Now, 7,220 rupees is the final cost of the sofa set. Now, this final cost of 7,220 is compared with the selling price, that is 8,000 rupees. Now, tell me children, whether it is profit or loss? Exactly. here it is profit. Why? Because SP is greater than CP. Okay, so here SP is greater than CP. When overhead charges are there, final cost is compared with the SP. Okay, children. So it is, yes or no, children? It is profit. So as you already know, to find profit, CP is subtracted from SP. Okay, children. Now, what is SP? 8,000 rupees minus, what is the final cost to CP? 7,220 rupees. Let us subtract. 8,000 minus 7,220 rupees. 0 minus 0, 0. 0 minus 2 is not possible. Subtraction with rupee. So here 8 will become 7. Here 0 will become 9. Here 0 will become 10. 10 minus 2, 8. 9 minus 2, 7. 7 minus 7, 0. So 780 rupees is the profit for the furniture mart. Thus, profit is 780 rupees. So children, like this, when overhead charges are given, overhead charges first we have to add to cost price to get the final cost, and then the final cost is compared with the SP to find out whether it is profit or loss. Children, practice the sums.
Children, it's time to recap. Sometimes the price of an object increases due to other expenses like transportation, shop rent, salaries, etc. These are called overheads, and these are added to the cost price. Final cost is equal to cost price plus overheads. Remember children, this final cost only we have to compare with the selling price to find out whether it is profit or loss. Remember children, overheads we have to add always to the cost price only. Practice the sums, children.